calm the fuck down. I gotta get a pump.
Yeah, take a moment. That's it. That's good.
What's up, guys? Alec Enkiri here, and welcome to another Conjugate-inspired training vlog. Here we'll be covering a week's worth of upper body training on my current Conjugate-style training program with the primary goal of achieving a 225-pound strict overhead press. So we'll cover two separate workouts here. My primary upper workout on Monday, followed by my secondary upper workout on Thursday. So kicking off here with Monday's workout, first thing I did was work my way up to a heavy single on the standing straight bar overhead press. And it wasn't bad work. I was working my way up in 20-pound jumps, and then I got to 185 pounds, which I kind of threw way out in front of me. And so that made it somewhat grindy of a lift. So after that, I took just a 5-pound jump up to 190 pounds just to secure a top single there for the session. And I think based on how smooth that 190 was, how well that it moved, that 195 would have been in the cards here on this day. But after that subpar lift with 185 pounds, I kind of decided that this was enough of a win, and I stopped it there, and I moved on to the next portion of the workout. And for that, it was rows with some volume overhead work. So for the rows lately, what I've been doing is just kind of tinkering around and trying to find some new movements. And so I came up with this chest-supported cable row using one of my benches. Now, overall, this movement feels great, honestly, but this particular bench makes it suboptimal because it kind of cuts the range of motion a little bit too much. And so I've actually improved upon this quite a bit in the last few weeks, as I recently purchased a standalone adjustable bench mainly to use for high incline presses and seated overhead presses, as well as a variety of dumbbell presses. But it's also better suited for these chest supported cable rows too. So you got it gives me more range of motion, basically. So you guys will kind of see that coming up in the next few weeks. Whenever I get around to making those training vlogs, you'll see that bench start to appear in some of the workouts. Now, overall, this can be kind of a pain in the ass getting this whole setup together, because it can be kind of hard to find the right everything, getting everything exactly how you want it, basically, to where you can get a stretch on the back muscles in the bottom position, but then still actually be able to grab a hold of the handle and pull the weight out of the pulley. So it can be hard to find the exact right setup, but once you feel it out, once you figure it out, it works pretty well. You can get a pretty good stretch on the back muscles, and then the contraction in the end range position is pretty much unmatched, at least as far as horizontal rowing variations for home gym owners go. Obviously, a lot of the chest supported rowing machines out there are going to be far superior to this type of a setup, but as a home gym owner, you make do in the best ways that you can, and sometimes that involves jerry-rigging some shit that works almost just as good. Now, for the volume overhead work, I was using the Swiss bar here, and my goal was just to work my way up to a tough set of 8 reps, and you guys are going to notice that I'm starting to lean pretty heavily on the Swiss bar in a lot of these workouts coming up for a lot of my different pressing variations, as I find that it produces a smooth pressing pattern with pretty low shoulder stress, and it forces you to use a good bit less weight as well on a lot of different variations, as it's a more mechanically disadvantageous pressing pattern due to the construction of the bar, which makes it sit farther out in front of you, farther away from your hips. So for this ramp up segment, I started off easy just with 125 pounds, then I jumped to 135, and then finally I finished up with a tough but solid set of 145 pounds for 8 clean reps. So it's a strong closeout to the secondary portion of this workout. And then I rounded out the day with some lew raises and some upper back biased inverted rows. Now, for that inverted row, like I said, you can see I'm deliberately trying to bias the upper back and the rear delts. I'm basically just pulling to the neckline instead of pulling to the belly or the abdominal area. And I like these as an easy way to get in some cheap volume for the upper back. So you'll kind of see, you'll see later in the video in the secondary workout later in the week. I do basically the same thing, but I treat that one more like an actual face pull by attaching my D handles to a barbell and inverting myself that way. We'll get to that in a minute though. And then I knocked out some blue raises here to close things out, just three sets in the 12 to 15 rep range using the 25 pounders. I'm still working on cleaning up the blue raise so that I can use the 35s, but I just haven't been doing the exercise consistently enough lately to really see any further progress with it. Unfortunately, I'm doing what I can though. I just haven't had enough time to incorporate all the different movements that I want to incorporate in my training program lately. So that wraps up the primary upper body day on Monday. And now moving on to the secondary upper body day on Thursday. Here, I use a similar format as earlier in the week, but in general, the reps are gonna be a little bit higher here. So instead of ramping up to a heavy single on the main movement, here I ramp up to a heavy set of five instead. And on this day, I was using the pin overhead press again with the Swiss bar. Like I said, I've been leaning pretty heavily on that Swiss bar for these pressing movements, and I was able to get in some really high quality work in this session. I did my little warm-up segment and whatnot, which I don't always show all that stuff in the video, which is why I made that video about proper warm-ups a couple weeks ago. So I start off here. The ramp up portion, I start off in earnest with 105 pounds. Knocked out five clean ones with it, made the jump to 125, did the same thing. After that, it was 140, 155, and finally 165 pounds for five reps for a strong and solid top set in this session using the Swiss bar, man. So overall, that's really good stuff. I really enjoy pressing off pins in general, but the Swiss bar is just its own different type of beast for this exercise. It feels really smooth off the shoulders, basically right up until about the forehead area. And then the bar really just kind of hits you like a ton of bricks at that point. So I need to focus personally on getting a little bit of layback here as I get to that midway point of the press to help try to get the upper chest involved. And then when I do that, I'm really able to find smooth execution on a lot of those tough reps. It's easier said than done because this bar is constantly trying to run away from you. But overall, this was really good work here. I think I executed well for the most part. I got in some really high quality reps on the way up the ramp as well, which is also very important. And then I basically picked a perfect weight to use for the top set of the day also. So there's not really anything for me to complain about, is there? After the primary ramp up here, I moved on to the secondary portion of the workout. And in this slot, I've been pairing a horizontal press with a vertical pull. But here, I kept the horizontal press, but then I swapped the vertical pull for another horizontal pull, just because I think that the horizontal pulling movements are a little bit more in line with my current set of goals. So I'm using a bit more volume horizontally now, currently, instead of vertically, which is a change up for me, honestly. Now, in this case, I went with the reclined cable row. Again, this one I just kind of made up in my search for ways to get in chest supported pulling variations within the limitations of my home gym setup. And the cable, that just feels smoother for me in general and better for me in general, so at least in this regard. So that's what I've been leaning on more heavily as of late. And the reclined version here, it works pretty well. The reclined cable row, you get kind of a hybrid between a chest supported and a non-chest supported movement with the reclined cable row, because you have to set the bar, the seatbelt bar that keeps you in place, low enough so that it doesn't impede the handle, doesn't impede your ability to row the actual weight. So I've been setting it up right around the upper abdomen and then pulling the bar to the nipple line. So I'm mostly locked in when I do it, but I can use a little bit of upper back flexion. That allows me to get those muscles under a stretch in the end range, and then it gives me kind of a little bit more oomph as I move into the contracted position. So it's not really a staple movement, but it is a keeper. And for the horizontal press in this workout, I was using the Swiss bar, and I did Larson presses off pins with it. And I've basically been doing Larson presses pretty much exclusively in this slot, either using a close grip on a straight bar, a close grip on my axle bar, which is a new purchase that I just made recently, or that neutral close grip like I'm doing in this workout on the Swiss bar. And overall, I'm incredibly weak on all of these variations. I'm mostly using the pins to force me to do dead stop presses and mimic kind of the constraints of overhead pressing a little bit more closely. as I don't really care about horizontal presses. I don't have any horizontal pressing goals right now. And it's kind of the same with the close grip. I'm using that to give me more range of motion and give me a grip width that's a little bit more similar to my overhead pressing grip width. And I'm actually a remarkably bad close grip bench presser as well. So working all these really weak variations is probably a good thing for me. Another weakness I've discovered recently is my upper chest area, or whatever you want to call it. I'm also a very, very weak incline bench presser. So a high incline bench with that new bench that I just bought, I've started doing a lot more work on a high incline around that 70 or 80 degree area where you still keep the shoulder engagement high, but you're also able to incorporate a lot more of the chest as well. I guess the upper chest, right? I'm actually weaker this way on an 80 degree incline than I am doing a standing overhead press, which is kind of sad. So I've been forcing myself to incorporate more variations like this these last few weeks since I made that purchase. And I'm gonna use those movements, those high incline movements, to replace the horizontal pressing that I'm showing you guys in this video. Anyway, that's all I got for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one. Hope you found it useful and informative. And I hope it gives you some good ideas to implement into your own training moving forward as well. I just published a new article on my Patreon this past week for those who are interested. It's called Progress Comes in Spurts. So be sure to check that one out. Pretty interesting topic, in my opinion. With the $5 tier and above, you get access to all my Patreon exclusive content, as well as training programs, form checks, Discord server access, and more. Be sure to check out EnkiriElitefitness.com for online coaching and training programs, and keep training hard. I will catch you guys next time.